Why is fudge barking?
Because he wants attention.
His noise is coming in the background. This AC's water noise is coming. Women give women so much shade for period because they're like, if you have it easy, you just expect everybody to have it easy. It's not like that. And dude. Hi you guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. For today's video, I am doing a full face of makeup. All of the makeup I have on my face right now are all women-owned businesses. These are all some badass women who've created such amazing makeup that this is so out of my comfort zone, but I enjoyed doing this thoroughly. And while I was doing my makeup today, I discussed a lot of women-related issues that we all have in this society. I took a community post as well as a question box on Instagram and I asked y'all the one time you felt like your gender was a hindrance to your happiness, and so many of y'all shared so many stories with me, your personal experiences, personal stories, and so much that I spent all morning today just reading through them and relating to them and trying to find my own experiences and understand from where y'all are coming. Of course, I can't relate to every single thing everyone has to say, but from everything that I read, I feel I'm so much more connected to you. And I realize at the end of the day, no matter what you are or who you are, we all somewhere, somehow face the same journey of being a woman. So that's what I want to just share with y'all today. I think just having this community to share this with and celebrate Women's Day together, discussing our problems, but also uplifting each other. That's what we are going to do in today's video. If this is the first time you've come here, then hi, I'm Sarah. I make beauty and lifestyle content here on YouTube. I try to keep my content very relatable and honest. So take a moment and hit the subscribe button. Join the Sarah squad. I'm sure you'll have a great time here. And also click the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. And with that, let's dive straight into this. Okay, so let's do this. I want to do my eyeshadow first because if there's any fallout, then we can deal with that later. My skin is super clean right now. I just went ahead and washed it with my Dermaviv Hydra Cleanser. Next for skin prep, I'll use my Nutriderm Vitamin E Moisturizing Lotion. I'll take a little bit on my finger. I'm going to massage this on my face. Works as a really, really good makeup base and also hydrates the skin really well. Adding this well into my skin, I'm also going to go ahead and use my Eclat Pro Makeup Primer. I want to prime my skin beforehand. This is more of a dewy primer, so I use it like a moisturizer. Sort of, it's not really pore minimizing, but it makes my makeup last really long. Let's zoom in and head on with our eye makeup. For eyeshadow, I have this very interesting palette. This is the Cuffs and Lashes x Shy Styles palette. Cuffs and Lashes in itself is a women-owned brand. It's owned by Nidhi Katyar. She's an Indian beauty YouTuber. And it's also in collaboration with Shy Styles, who's another YouTuber. So this is the gorgeous four colored palette that they collaborated on. It has all these four gorgeous palettes inside the one eyeshadow palette in itself. So we have a blue palette, a green palette, a purple, and a warm toned red palette. It has a very similar vibe to the Colorboard palette by Beauty Glazed. I also have the brushes by Cuffs and Lashes. This is also in collaboration with Shy Style. So I'm going to be trying this for the first time today. I am going to be doing a dedicated review video on everything from Cuffs and Lashes. I have placed an order for another bulk of makeup, but today let's try this for the first time. I want to go with the blue palette because it's been a while since I've experimented with color. I really want to step out of my comfort zone, and this palette has such gorgeous shades. It's my first time trying it. I'm using the CS02. Before that, I'm just gonna prime my lids. I'm using the Pack Take Cover Concealer for that. Taking this nice teal blue color. I really hope the payoff is good. There's no kickback as such on the palette. So the first topic I think we should take is periods. I think the most questioned about topic was that women are unhappy about their periods, because I understand it can be very painful. We take it as a joke, and so many times at work or even amongst friends who don't have their periods that bad, we are told that, okay, you're just like PMSing, you know, it's given off as such an excuse. With my personal experience, I'll tell you, I took OC pills, that is oral contraceptives, for a really long time for my PCOS. And so those days when I was taking the OC pills, I used to never have like PMS symptoms. My periods were a breeze. I would never be able to relate to period pain or cramps or any of that. But now I'm completely off my meds, and now when I get my period, it's horrible. Like, horrible is not the word. The pain is bad, the cramps are bad, the mood swings are legit. Like, it's your hormones are just playing a game with you. They come every month and you literally have to pray for them to come every month, because if they're irregular and you miss a period, then next month it's gonna get worse because the pain only aggravates. So I think period sympathy is something we need to all learn, especially if you have endometriosis and stuff like this goes undiagnosed as well, because they just diss period pain as period pain and just take a painkiller and end it. But more often than not, when later on you try to conceive and actually look into fertility issues, you realize you've had endometriosis for the longest time. So endometriosis is basically like a condition where your uterus lining becomes thick and it also goes and encompasses the ovaries and like other organs. When that starts happening, every time your uterus lining is shedding during your period, it is causing a lot of pain, and it is so painful when you have endometriosis that, you know, some people just take an off from work and life in general. Next time I'm taking the CS04 and I'm taking a little bit of the darker shade. This is Blissful. It's a dark navy teal color. I'm gonna put it on the outer corners. Well pigmented eyeshadow, really well pigmented. The light blue was a little bit of a turn off, it wasn't that well pigmented, but this darker one is really good. With periods, I think even another issue is you can't swim, you can't go in water and all of that, and I completely relate. You see the boys all go in the pool and jump in the pool, and you have to plan your vacations as per your period cycle, and it can be really irritating. I have been there, done that. If you are not bleeding that heavily, you can wear a tampon and go in the pool. That is like on your 4th or 5th day of your period. So in case you didn't know that, then pro tip. Since we are already on the topic of periods and pregnancy and conception, I think also when you deal with issues like PCOS, when you deal with endometriosis, and conditions like this are so difficult to deal with. They don't really have one sure shot cure. Everybody has a different clinical picture. I think PCOS is a very personal journey, and with that comes a lot of issues when you're trying to conceive and you know, when you go in for pregnancy and stuff like that. But I know that just being told how much of a woman you are just because you can't conceive or can be very disheartening. All of this can place such a strong like impact on your mental health. Put yourself in that person's shoes and imagine, like, if I was there, I would be completely shattered, disheartened. And then if you have family pressure, it can be really taxing, like really taxing. And I can totally understand. You not only need fertility drugs and fertility treatment, but also mental health treatment to go through that journey. I've seen Desi Perkins' entire fertility journey, and I know from books and everything of how much you have to do. But then adoption is always an option. Like, I honestly feel it's sometimes better than having to go through so much pain. But then again, I'm not in that shoes, so I will not speak with experience. I'm just speaking very subjectively. So let's move on to the next topic. Moving on to a little bit of a lighter topic, that has been deadlines. Yes, deadlines and being given curfews and all of this, which have always, I think, been for girls more than boys. And now, personally, again, can't relate, because I don't really have a brother and my parents didn't really give us like deadlines as such, like you have to be home at this time. They would also, of course, like message us and call us and ask us where are you if we got late. But they never really told us you cannot be out of the house after so and so time, which is why I could not understand why my friends, like other friends, would have issues. Oh my god, look at this color flip. It's really beautiful. It's like so pretty, dude. And there's like no fallout. Can you see this? Like, I was expecting there to be so much fallout, which is why I did my eyeshadow first. But this is gorgeous, huh? This quality is so bomb. I know I've heard so many good things of Cuffs and Lashes, but I didn't expect it to be so good. For the price of it, I think it's a steal. I'm gonna take a more of a darker blue and like pack it in, so I get a really nice depth in my eyeshadow. And yeah, as we were talking about deadlines, I think girls definitely do have, and it comes from a place of like comfort and safety. When you're like out too late, like people are staring at you, they give you like, how are you out so late? And if I say it's normal for me to be out after 12 o'clock, it's such a big question mark for so many people. I have been out after 12 for so long. Because of that, I felt very independent at a very young age, because I was never really told that you have to be home because you're a girl. My parents did, like, they checked up on me, they called me, they messaged me if it like went past my safe time, not really a curfew, but then they never really told me that be home at this time or so and so, but never to like come home or like, you know, I'm waiting for you to sleep and all of that kind of was not the scene. So I can understand, like, if my friends had those scenes, it kind of got tough for us also to like be out for very late, which is when my friends would like stay over at my place, because then it would be convenient because they never had to then go back home and like face the curfews and the deadlines. From the topic of deadlines also comes the topic of wearing short clothes or wearing indecent clothes as per a lot of people, and that is like a topic that literally triggers me, because this is something I personally also faced at home. This is something that was for the longest time a big question mark, that I could not wear sleeveless, I could not wear short clothes, and it was always like a thing that the area that we stayed in before was really conservative, and the men over there were so they used to like stare at you from the top to the bottom. Like every time I would wear anything, even jeans and top, I would feel like my fly is open. I would never wear dresses and go out. I would wear dresses and then like wear jeans under and then remove it in the cab, which was worse personally for me. But just to not be stared at in the area I stayed, I had to make that measure and take that step. And I'm sure a lot of girls can relate, and that sucks, because men can wear whatever the fuck they want and just get out of the house. You're never judged at, looked at, or stared at like you're going to be raped any second. But women always have that, and you don't feel safe. Even after staying in a city, if that's how I feel, then I can just imagine, like, if you're in a smaller town or if you're like a little bit in the rural areas, then what is the scene? This glitter is very easy to work with, that I really like, but the mattes are taking a lot of effort to like show up and blend. I think the mattes could have been a little more pigmented. I am using bluer tones, so maybe that is why it's more difficult for me to work with them. The shimmers are definitely the winner and the star of the show today. Talking about opinions, so now women are always being told that you can't be very opinionated, you can't be very loud for a woman. These are certain things that even I have heard so often from my relatives and my family. You all know I'm very opinionated. I have an opinion for almost everything. And I take a lot of pride in that, because for me to form opinions, it's difficult. I never just say things for the heck of it. I will observe, analyze, see the patterns, see my own personal experience, and then form an opinion. So just shutting my opinion because I'm a girl or because I'm a woman in a public conversation is not okay. Why would I not? Why would my gender discriminate that? I have taken the same amount of education. I know what I'm talking. I do my research when I'm talking. My gender does not describe or discriminate anything, okay? There are so many men who don't have that much knowledge about what they are talking, but it's a man who's talking, they are given more respect. And this I've seen even at workplaces. Now I have never been to a 9-to-5 job, but I have heard that, and y'all also told me this when y'all rented your hearts out, that y'all have been the more capable ones but not gotten the promotion only because y'all were a woman in the team, and the man easily gets a promotion or easily gets the project because he's a man. And that sucks, dude. Like, I can't even imagine a level of workplace harassment that is not direct, it's indirect. And I think gender bias at workplace should really end, be it anything for that matter, of your promotions, your salaries, the way you work, how much work you are supposed to do. Next, I'm taking the Debashree Beauty Define Eyeliner. This is, of course, Debashree Banerjee's brand. She's also an Indian YouTuber. So it's another women-owned company. I'm taking the yellow shade because it's my favorite. I'm taking the CS08, the Cuffs and Lashes and Shy Styles brush. And I'm gonna use this where I've cut my crease, just above the glitter. I'm gonna take the Kiro Beauty black eyeliner and I'm gonna draw a sharp wing with it. The yellow eyeliner was a little difficult to work with on this side because it's like water activated liners. I have a complete review on them, you can check it out here. But it was thought as a difficult to work over here, but here it's like perfect. So this is my profile side, so we'll just pose on this side and call it a day. I'm just gonna clean up all of the mess on my face and then we'll do our full face makeup, then complete the eyes. So I use the eyeliner by Kiro Beauty and I wanted to check if it's a woman-owned company, and it's actually by Vasundhara Patni. She's a CEO mom and she's launched this company during the pandemic, so I had no idea about this. She has two kids and she's launched a brand new business, which is a clean beauty brand. This is not sponsored by them, anyhow. I just wanted to look it up because I didn't really check this before I sat to film the video, but that is so cool. I actually love the products I have from Kiro. This eyeliner is one of my favorites. I think just listening to such stories is so motivating and positive, because seeing women in business is like the dream. It's the positive change I want to see in society one day. Let's go in with foundation. I'm using using the NYX Cosmetics Can't Stop Won't Stop foundation. I'm using it in the shade Golden Honey. I don't know if you know this, but NYX is also a women-owned business. I'm not very sure of the name of the person, but I know it's a woman. It's by Toni Ko. She's an American businesswoman. And NYX is one of the biggest drugstore makeup companies we have in the US. And they have some great quality makeup. So I love that. Plus, they have so much variety in foundations. And the pricing is also really affordable. And I'm going to go in with the Henna sponge. This is also a women-owned business. It's owned by the owner of International Makeup India and Henna Beauty. And she's also a new mom. So she's literally in business right now, launching products and doing her entire thing while also being an amazing mother. I think that's super amazing. I love following her on Instagram. Then they reached out to me and sent me their products, and their products are so good in quality and so luxury. Like, I love their blushes, I love the sponge, and also lashes. This is, I think, all they have right now in their inventory. I think when it comes to going against society norms and starting something, going the unconventional way, there are definitely a lot of people who will judge you, a lot of people who will call you too bold, too brave to be a woman, or too loud to be a woman. But those are the people who don't matter. Those are the people whose opinions you don't have to take, even if they personally do matter to your life, like if it's your own close family doing that, because it can be the scene. Not every family is supportive and not all two people think alike. But if you believe in yourself 100%, you can't change the world, but you can change the way you perceive the world, right? That's how I've always thought. If something affects me, or if that person's thought process affects me, then I stop giving into that thought process, because of their negativity, I can't change my own vibe and my own personalities. Either distance yourself from those people and continue to be yourself. I would have never continued my channel. I would have never. There were so many people in my family who told me that I should not continue. Not like my close family at home, I'm talking about my extended family. They had all the wrong reasons to tell me why I should not do what I'm doing. I have heard all sorts of things because I come from a very mixed background. So to respect everyone, I never tell them this is what I feel on the face, but I will continue to do what I do. In a way, that is me respecting my own boundaries while also respecting them, because honestly, they are not coming home to really govern what I do every day, and their opinions should not change my own, or the way other people perceive what you do should not stop you. For concealer, I'm just going to go in with the PAC Take Cover Concealer, and I'm just going to conceal and brighten my under eyes. PAC is not a women-owned business, but it is a good business, and I don't have a concealer from a women-owned business. For powder, I'm going to use the K by Katrina Loose Powder. And of course, this is Katrina Kaif's brand. So the founder of this company is a woman-owned business. I'm taking the Cuffs and Lashes CS12 brush. These brushes are really good, by the way. And the bristles are also not flaking on my skin. I really like the brush quality. Next, for bronzer, I'm taking Ofra Cosmetics Bronzer. Ofra is also a woman-owned business. It's owned by Ofra herself. That's the name of the woman who owns the company. I think as I bronze my skin, let's dive into a little bit more of a serious topic, a topic that can be a trigger to some. So in case it is, I think you should drop off. And that is rape and sexual harassment and molestation. I can tell you that I was once in a situation that I was really close to being like, literally, if I was like not quick enough, could have been raped. But public molestation, being inappropriately touched at public places, in public transport, at buses, all of this is something I'm pretty sure every girl or every woman has faced once in her life. I wouldn't even say it happens more in cities or it happens less in rural areas. It just happens. And that's so not okay, because I know for a fact that this lacks so much in India. And at this point, it actually makes me angry that we've had to face all of this at a very young age, been traumatized by all of this, and people still think it's okay to not give the correct sex ed and to only give it to women. And when it comes to sex ed in India, all we talk about is periods, and that's so wrong. You need to teach both boys and girls what is a good touch, what is a bad touch, what is inappropriate touching. You need to know when you're being molested, because more often than not, you don't even know what is happening to you. You don't know what is going on until you're like much later, and then you look back and reflect and realize that that was completely wrong because it was not consensual. I just want to tell all my girls out there who are young, if you're at a public transport, if you're in a situation where you feel you're not comfortable, if somebody's rubbing against you, if somebody's trying to touch you and you don't feel comfortable, you scream. You literally scream. Don't even think twice. Scream make noise, make it happen, like stop. Because men more often than not don't understand a simple no, and just distancing yourself, that person might still try to follow you. So scream, ask for help, and don't be afraid of doing that. But screaming, making noise, and actually escaping that place, when you make noise, that person gets distracted and everybody around you gets alert, because it's better to be in the known than to be in the unknown and let it happen to you and then be traumatized for life. For blush, I'm going to take my Rare Beauty blush. This is of course Selena Gomez's own brand, and since it's a liquid blush, I should have ideally used it before I used my powder, but we'll try to make it work. I'm taking a little bit on my hand. This is the shade Happy. It's a very pretty color. I'm taking this on the cuffs and lashes, CS11. I'm just going to stipple it very lightly on my cheeks. It's very pink actually. I wouldn't really choose this blush with this eye look, but I definitely had to feature Selena Gomez's brand because I love her. For highlighter, I'm taking the Fenty Beauty highlighter in the shade Fenty Glow Diamond Bomb. This is actually a pressed highlighter, so using it with my finger is actually the best thing. Fenty is of course Rihanna's brand. We all love Rihanna. We love her music, love her makeup. Fenty was actually the first makeup company that came up with 50 shades in foundation, which was literally the peak of inclusivity, because everyone had a shade to choose from, and the Fenty Beauty foundation is so good. My foundation is over and I've wanted a refill for the longest time, but then COVID hit and nobody's really traveling. And since we are on the topic of skin color and inclusivity, I also thought I would talk about body shaming and skin shaming that we've all, I think, faced once in life for sure. Based on how you look, though, everybody loves to judge on how you look. They love to say that you're too dark, you're too fat, you're too skinny, you need to eat or you don't need to eat, and everybody thinks they have something to say about the way you look. And somehow all of this comes to target with you will get married or no. You're too tall, you won't find a groom to get married. You're too dark, maybe you should become a little more fairer to get married. You won't be able to find a suitable groom to get married. At this point, toh maine sabhi sun liya. Every time I would go to a new wedding as a child or a growing teenager and I would become a little more taller, they all would be only concerned ki ladka nahi milega. As if I am growing tall to satisfy some man's ego. Like, what is the connection? Once I literally came home from a wedding and cried my ass out ki I'm not gonna go to shadis anymore because this is all I get to hear. That time I was a growing teen who was very insecure of her height, and I was the tallest person in class always, and it was not the most secure thing. Of course, now everybody loves my height and wants to know how tall I am, because the way I carry it off today, you like the way I look in my height. But initially I was not that confident in my height. I think everybody's perspective just changes if you're confident about the way you look. So if you're a growing teen and if you're watching this and if you're insecure about the way you look, or you are told that you will not find a suitable someone to marry you because of the way you look, either shush them, or if you can't shush them, just carry your weight, carry your skin tone so well, so confidently, that unko farak hi, like tumko farak nahi padna chahiye ki wo tumhare bare mein kya bole. Next, I'm going to set my face. I'm using the Milani Make It Last setting spray, and Milani is also a woman-owned company. It is owned by Grace Ray. I looked all of this up, okay? I just had to search that in my collection, how many women-owned businesses do I have, and I'm so happily surprised that I have so many women-owned makeup companies with me. For my lower lash, I'm using the same Cuffs and Lashes palette. I'm gonna take the darker blues and I'm going to smoke out my lower lash line with it. To set my brows in place, I'm taking the Fay Beauty brush. This is in the shade Dark Brown. I really like this as a brow gel. I filled my brows with the Miniso eyebrow pencil, and then I like to go over with this. Fay is also a women-owned company. It's owned by Karishma, and they stand for free and equal beauty. So they have only 2 products as of now and some merchandise, if I'm not wrong. And I love how they hold their campaigns. Like, everything is so inclusive. Plus this particular product, brush, it's so easy to use. It fills in my brows perfectly. Like, I don't even need to fill my brows sometimes on a daily basis if I'm just using this. All of their campaigns always include women of all sizes, skin tones and everything. And I think all Indian companies need to do this. If you go on the website, you should feel like you're invited there. Finally, for lipstick, I'm using the Cal Los Angeles X Gurish Kaur lipstick. I'm really not sure, and I could not find it on the internet, who the CEO or owner or founder of Cal Los Angeles is. But Gurishk is a dear friend and is also a beauty creator, and she's a woman boss lady. She's so young, she's younger to me as well, and she has this in collaboration with Cal, which is a beautiful lipstick formula. This is the shade Ola. The color is really pretty, but it's not tying with the eye look. So I'm going to take Huda Beauty's Spice Girl. Huda Beauty is of course owned by Huda herself. This is a nice dark color, so I'm hoping this ties the look together. For kajal, I'm using the K by Katrina kajal, and I'm using it in the shade Spade. Alrighty guys, so I went off camera and just added this bobby pin and some false eyelashes. The false eyelashes I'm using are by Henna Henna Beauty. This is in the shade Haya. It's really pretty and really nice if you have like hooded eyes because it makes the eyeshadow pop through. And with that, we complete this full face of glam using all women-owned businesses. I hope you guys enjoyed. It was so empowering for me to actually sit down and use all this makeup knowing that some badass women have created it. And also to discuss all your issues that you all actually went on record to share with me. These were all such personal topics and you all have written such long stories in my question box and my community post, and I actually went ahead to read all of them this morning. Like, I wanted to read and connect with you all before I actually sat down to share my personal experiences, my journey, or my thoughts and opinions on them. I'm no expert in all of this. I purely come from a place of experience of being a girl just like you, and that was my intention behind today's video, to just like give you all a space to share your problems and maybe just, you know, share our pain, because all of this sort of holds back a lot of us in a lot of different ways. I think the buy all and end all of everything is to just be confident the way you are. If you start embracing how you look, what you are, and what your journey truly is, then nothing will stop you. No time will be a boundary. Nobody's rules and opinions about you will stop you, and you'll just be able to get where you are. So just look at yourself in the mirror every day and remind yourself that you've been through so much, you're going through so much, but you have such a long journey ahead of you. I hope this video inspired you. I hope we continue to be on this journey, and I'm so blessed to have this community where we can share so much of personal information and just be so close and tight-knit. I love you all so much. A very happy Women's Day to all of us. And for today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Suma Adiga. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, hit the subscribe button, bell icon right next to it, and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sara Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video Sara Squad shout out. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, love you, take care. Mwah.